Hi, welcome to the discussion of orthographic projections. In the case of orthographic projections, what we have to do is, the pictorial view is given in the problem. From that pictorial view, we have to convert it into orthographic projections. That is, this is the given pictorial view. What they are asking, draw the front view, top view, right side view of the figure. Front view, top view, right side view of the figure, and the dimensions are in millimeters. That is, pictorial view is given in the problem. From that pictorial view, we have to convert into two-dimensional drawings, that is orthographic projections. So first of all, what we have to do is, we have to decide what is the direction of arrow. This is the direction of arrow. This direction of arrow indicates the front view. The direction of this arrow indicates the front view. So the direction of arrow related measurement will be the length. That means this is going to be the length, and this is the breadth, and this one will be the height. So first of all, we have to decide length, breadth, and height. So the 96 is the length, 64 is the breadth, and 64 is the height of the object. Coming to the front view. Front view, what are the dimensions are visible? And what are the images are visible to us? Those images I am shading. Say, this particular shaded region is visible in the front view. This particular object and the second one and this third one, these three parts are visible in the front view. What about top view? In the case of top view, this shaded region, plus even top, the shaded region also visible. That is, this region is visible both in front view as well as top view. That is, this green color shaded region is visible in the top view. The direction of side view is chosen right side of the object. This is for side view and this is for top view. That is, so left side length, right side breadth, and this one is the overall height of the object. Now we'll start the drawing front view of the object as well as top view and then side view. Before doing that, what we have to do is, we have to draw xy line, so that we'll draw front view as well as top view. After that, we have to draw another reference line for drawing the side view. As we are using first angle projection, the front view comes above the XY line, top view comes below the XY line, side view comes adjacent to the front view, that is above XY line. As a first step, draw XY line, say X and Y, and X1 and Y1 line, X1 and Y1 line. As a first step, draw XY line. After that, draw X1 and Y1 line. That is, here this particular region we are going to draw the front view, here top view, and then here side view, here side view. So for drawing the side view, I am drawing 45 degrees line. Next, so I'll start doing the front view. So in the case of front view, what are the dimensions visible to us? Say 96 length and height is 16, and again going back left, and again height is here, say 64 minus this 16, that is total height is 64. So as a first step, we have to draw this particular image. Even though it is a curved one, both in front view as well as top view, it looks like a straight. So as a first step, what you have to do, draw 96 length line, after drawing 96 length, then height is how much? 16. This height is 16. After that, here this total height from here is 64. And then this length is how much? This length 16. And then down 48. And then join this length. That is, this is height and this is length. So drawing this particular first part is over. Then this particular rectangle with half round, this is semicircle shape is visible. So those measurements are, from here to there it is 8, and here to there it is 8, and diameter of the semicircle 24, 8, here also 8. After that, here with a radius of 12, we have to draw the, after drawing the semicircle, then the second part is over. Second part, 8, 24 diameter of the semicircle, and 8 is the again length. Then the third part is slant one, where it is, because this breadth is looks like a point in front view, as if this particular slant line looks placed over this particular corner and joined to this particular rectangle corner. And then after that, in front you, even this line is visible. This particular rectangle line is visible. Next, what about this empty space? Is it visible in the front view? In front view, it is not visible. It is not visible. Up to 20 mm, up to 20 mm, it is like a flat, then semicircular hole is there. Then semicircular hole is there. From this corner at a distance 20 mm, from this corner at a distance 20 mm. The distance 20 mm, as we have to draw the axis line. In the case of semicircle or circular objects, we have to draw the axis line. Then the diameter of it is 16 mm, that is radius is 8 mm. So at a distance 8 mm, draw dotted line as it is not visible, as it is not visible. So drawing the front view is over. Now we'll draw top view. In the case of top view, we're able to see this particular rectangle, that is 16 by 64 rectangle and 8 by this remaining length of this rectangle. And this particular rectangle is visible, and this particular rectangle also visible. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are the images visible in the top view. So we'll draw projectors from the front view towards the horizontal plane for drawing the top view. So from various corners of the front view, draw projectors. So after drawing the projectors, then this first rectangle, that is 16 length and 64 breadth. So here what we are doing is we are transferring the length from front view to the top view. So length is a common, this is the length. So breadth comes in this way, and then breadth is how much? 64. That is this total, 16 by 64. This is 16 and this is 64. Drawing the 16 by 64 rectangle is over, and then this particular shape, we'll draw it. This line, that is this line is over. Then here how much? 16 breadth. Again with a gap of 16, again remaining portions straight. This is breadth portion. After that, of drawing this one and this one, this particular hole from here at a distance 20. And then radius of this one is 8 mm. With compass, we have to draw this radius. Drawing this whole portion also over. Then come to this second one. Second one, length is how much? 8 mm. Length is 8 mm. And breadth is how much? 42. This breadth is 42. Even here also, length is 8 mm. And breadth is 42. I mean, this is the length and this one is the breadth. And here, even though it is a curved surface, it looks like a straight. Even though it is a curved surface, even though it is a curved surface, it looks like a straight in the top view. That curved surface exactly visible only in the front view. As it is a curved surface, because it is a radial object, we have to draw the axis line. Here we have to draw axis line. Drawing second, third, and this one also over fourth one. Fourth one from here with a breadth of 12 mm. From here with a breadth of 12 mm, we have to draw this rectangle. We have to draw this rectangle. After drawing front view, top view, then draw side view. For that, what we have to do is, we have to project the projectors from top view towards the profile plane, and again projectors from the front view towards the profile plane. Now I am projecting the projectors from the top view. Draw projectors from the one front view also. After drawing the projectors from top view as well as front view, then see the image of the object at right side. Image of the object at right side. Clear portion. In the side view, we were able to see this particular square and this particular square and this particular rectangle and this rectangle and this particular region and this total arc. This arc is visible in the side view, whereas the semicircle is invisible. The semicircular hole is invisible in side view. As a first step, 16 by 16 here, 16 by 16, and then this one also 16, this one also 16, and then remaining breadth. This breadth is 16 here, 16 here, remaining total breadth is 64. Total breadth is 64 and height of it is 16. Height of it is 16. This portion is over. Then this is this in the side view, even though it's a slant, it looks like a straight. Breadth of it is 12 and height is 28. And breadth is 12. And then this particular total that is 64 minus 22, that is total breadth of 42. By 28 rectangle, this is total 42. This total 42 by 28 rectangle is visible. 42 by 28 rectangle is visible. Then what about the semicircle in the side view? It is not visible. So at what depth it is there as a hole? At a depth of 12 mm down. So here it is 12 mm invisible. So it is not, this hole is not visible in the side view. Then here this particular semicircular hole is there. So that hole, this edge and center line, we have to draw it. So here this is the center line. Then this portion, this hole and this rectangle and this rectangle and this rectangle, semicircle also over, only this arc is left over. For drawing the arc, they have given the radius as 48. So from here to there it is 64. So from here to there it is total breadth is 64. From this end to there, we have to locate a point distance of 48. Then we have to take the radius as 48 and draw an arc. That is, here with a radius of 48, we have to draw an arc. So for that, first of all, we have to locate the point at a distance of 48 from this end, as radius is given as 48. So drawing front view, top view and side view is completed. The next step is we have to do the dimensioning part. In the case of dimensioning, if length is chosen in the front view, then we should not do the dimensioning length in the top view. If height is mentioned in the side view, then no need to show that height in the front view. That is, dimensions should not be repeated. Now I'll do the dimension part. How much it is? 96. That's about doing the dimensioning and labeling like front view, top view and side view. I hope everyone understood very well. Thank you for listening my lecture.